Fishing for pike has got to be the most exciting way of catching this fierce predator. It's like doing the Cresta run on a tea tray. Charlie Battelle is probably the most famous lure fisherman in Britain. And most of Charlie's lures start their life like this.
Ideally, if you're going to say work in an inch diameter lure, you'd buy an inch and a quarter square block of wood. You can either whittle or go out and buy yourself a little hobby lathe and start lathing them up. A lot of lures I've sat down and made, I've had an idea. The idea has not worked. Instead of binning that particular lure, I've transformed it into something totally different to what I actually set out to achieve.
And what about the propeller blades? What are they for?
Giving off vibration and flash. And beside that, my ones are flat. They've got flash, they've got vibration, they've got everything going for them. I would say vibration is the utmost importance for lure fishing for any predatory fish. Big pike, like a big meal, big meals move slow, which is low frequency. So what I try to do is incorporate that into my lures. If I want big pike, I work them slow with a nice slow vibration. If I want smaller pike, high frequency vibration.
How did you first get interested in vibrations and frequency?
Well, years ago, CB radio, it was basically called in those days, which was a bit of a fad. I went a sort of stage beyond that and went into sideband radio, which was transmitting to all sorts of countries, talking to truckers and laybys in Turkey and all that. So I started thinking, well, vibrations. So I've got a big understanding of vibrations. I don't confess to be an expert on radio. I'm most certainly not. But I've got to understand vibrations and how they work and how I could talk to somebody in another country. My lures talk to pike. Come and get me.
What about colour?
In murky water conditions, I would say colour is not so important. Vibration is very important in murky water conditions. Clear water conditions where pike can see everything, very good clarity, then sometimes lures that are a bit over the top spotty wise are too much for the fish. They don't want to know, they're too weary of it.
What is it you like about pike?
What do I like about pike? Well, the sheer thrill of the fish. I mean, it's got tremendous power. You'll see it bow wave through on surface working lures. It's most probably the only fish you'll actually see bow waving up behind a lure, and you say to yourself, yeah, she comes here, she comes here, she... Ah! And you still jump with all that warning. Mm. And it's the only fish that will do it for you. It's the wolf, or should I say the shark of the fresh water. It comes through the water like a shark. And when it comes through the water, all your lure wants to do is get out of its way quick.
What's the strangest thing you can make a lure out of?
The strangest thing you can make a lure out of, I mean, as I said, it's endless, but I suppose one of my weirdest lures has to be a 35mm film canister filled with ball bearings. It's got a wire running through the middle. It's a prop blade at the front. It's got three blades coming off of it. Creates a lot of water disturbance. It's the noise again. It's the vibration that they're after.
Can you catch fish on that one?
Can I catch fish on that one?
So here we are, back on the Norfolk Broads with top lure man Charlie Battles, and we're fishing with things like this.
Trusty hog wobbler, the well-bitten hog wobbler.
Not the hog wobbler.
Yep.
Uh-oh.
The nice thing about this lure is we can work it top water like so.
Yeah.
Or I can crank it down. So I've got the best of both worlds out there. So if I actually have a pike come up and tap at it, I can actually just crank a little bit faster to get the lure to go down, then it's gone down into its domain,
into the front of his nose.
That's right. But mostly I want to pop it on the surface. And the nice thing about when this is working slow on the surface, you've got the little blade at the back's flashing away. It's flashing a little message out to the pike.
Oh, yeah.
Come and get me. Here you go. Oh, yes!
Oh!
Straight away! Oh, we are talking good fish.
G-
good change of lure, eh?
A good change of lure? Am I going to be able
to... Just the right moment.
I've got to keep the pressure on this fish, and I've got to get his head up and out of this lily bed there. This is a good bend on the rod.
Brilliant. Oh, I saw the tail come up then.
Oh, he's big. I don't know how big he is, but he's making himself feel big. Here he comes.
He was just hiding in this edge of that last lily pad, wasn't he?
Here he comes.
Yes.
I don't care how big he is. He's a fish.
Oh, look at him. Oh, those lilies in his head.
Look at that mouth on that.
Yeah.
Look at that mouth on that.
He snapped away at that.
He's actually... Is there three sets of trebles on that?
Whoa! Yes!
He's just got, somehow, got the wire caught around his... Right, if you can...
Shall I hand him out?
Well done, well done.
He's ours.
It's just tangled around his mouth.
I tangled that pike.
Look at that, not even hooked. Not even hooked.
It's very nice working something right over the top of the lilies like this, isn't it?
It is, it is. I mean, you know, I think you get so engrossed working your lure over that lily bed there, watching every direction your lure's trying to go, work it round this stem, working
That's
it round
right.
that flower.
When
the actual lure suddenly gets hit, I mean, shocking is not the word for it. Frightening,
There's a couple
is the
of sort of puddles in the middle, and you know, if you
That's
just
right.
get it into the puddly bit and splish it around in
yeah.
the water a bit.
Funny, because these pike are obviously well tuned to hitting these things off of these lily beds. I mean, and I never ever see things walking over these lily beds, so I don't know what it is they're actually doing.
Yeah, is it supposed to be frogs?
Possibly frogs or something, you know, and you're not there at the right time to see this happening, because they're obviously genned up to hitting these things on these top of these beds like this.
Think you're making enough noise down there?
Yeah. Yes! No! Oh, you little monkey!
That was just on that same bit on the edge of the weeds there. Here's a good looking one, this one. I tell you what, that was a take, another take, and then finally, this whole mother turns up.
Right, for here this is a specimen. Oh, it's a screamer.
She is a fantastic thing, isn't she?
A lovely fish. Take your time. Whoa! Take your time.
She's going to have your arm off this one.
Whoa,
it, Charlie.
This is a beaut.
She's going to have your arm off.
Take your time, Nick. Take your time. Look at that go. Look at that go.
Come on. Come on. It's a nice thing about this braid, is it?
Right, try and take the rod about... Take a little bit of line off, Nick, and take it behind your head.
Yeah.
No, she don't want to come
She's
in
She's taking
yet.
Line off for me. I don't have to take any line off.
She's a strong un.
She's great.
I told you these, these are torpedo pike, didn't I?
Whoa!
It's going to go.
Don't you just love me?
Try and keep that much line out now, Nick, and take the rod right behind your head.
Ooh.
Bail arm open, Nick.
Yep.
Oh, this is a beaut. Bail arm open.
It's open. She doesn't want to come in. She wants to go again.
You have got yourself one big mother here. You have got a big mother. Look at this baby. Put it there, son. Hey, look at that. Get your hands on that. Look at that baby!
Jesus, you can only just about see my lure down there. Look at this. Look at this!
Fantastic. This is what we come to Norfolk for. Great, big, sleek, sexy, gorgeous pike!
Don't drop away.
Just about take your arm off, your head off, your ear off. Look at this. A few leeches, a great big head, and teeth the size of your fist.
Great big thick skull.
Yes!